Hey. Well, I'm sorry it's been so long, but so much has happened. My first outing, I'm out at Grand Canyon. Yeah, that was my first place. Anyhow, I had to move. I spent my first 8 days up there. Absolutely no internet, no nothing. I was lucky to even get a phone call. It was beautiful, though. Beautiful, beautiful. Oh my God, the daytime is in the 70s and the night is in the 50s. What I did do though is I moved down the mountain just a little bit to get the internet, but I actually had to go all the way into Flagstaff because I woke up the other morning to an almost flat tire. Yes, my tire actually had a cut in it, and I know that it was a cut in it after I got up there because in Williams, Arizona, I had stopped to check all my tires and make sure that I had air. So anyway, no harm or foul. I did buy a new tire in Flagstaff, and I got back up here early this morning to a new spot down the mountain. Not as close to the mountain. I think it's like 10 miles out. But anyhow, I'll be here 14 days, and then I'll move on to my next adventure. But everything has gone okay. It's been, I guess that when you buy an RV, if things are gonna happen, they're gonna happen. Like the night I bought the RV, we had the AC going while we were loading it, and all of a sudden the breaker blew. Even the house I had it hooked up to, the main box went out, and I guess the battery that was being used for the house battery wasn't any good. And that just kind of finished it off because before I even turned on the AC unit, the little fire alarm CO2 detector was beeping. And it's wired like a house into your electrical system. So whether it was the battery blowing my electrical box or my electrical box blowing the battery or the AC unit, who knows? But I did all that work to set up solar and now I can't use it, but I will be buying a battery as soon as the beginning of October when I get paid again. I just don't have the funds to put out for a $100 battery right now because I had to buy a $120 tire yesterday. Yeah. There were like five cuts in it, and it was sun rotted. Absolutely, the tires needed replaced, especially that one. But the one particular thing that made it leak so bad was a cut, a knife cut. But not to worry, this girl's good. I hope you all are having a great, great time. I know the weather up here has been just amazing. It's rained every day. And you know what? Some days it's just a sprinkle, other days it's pounding. But I try to make sure I stay away from the other campers because I do have to run a generator right now. And it's because my batteries just don't last that long. But anyway, I do get TV. That's the trippiest part, okay? See my TV behind me? I have a 42-inch Hitachi. But anyway, it's so awesome to be able to plug in a DVD and watch a movie in my little house in the middle of nowhere. And coyotes, oh my God, there's so many coyotes and they scream like somebody's being murdered, like a woman. And they're very smart. They'll go around and flap my storage in the basement area. If it's not locked, those little things know how to open it. It's a trip. So anyway, it's quite interesting. I'm still trying to get my sense of security and my comfort zone. But little by little, it's coming. I just wanted you all to know that I've made other videos, but I want this one out right now so that you all know that I'm thinking about you. I may not be able to upload the other ones right away, but I will see to it that this one gets uploaded today. Anyway, I wish you all the best. Remember to love yourself, because if you don't love you, then nobody's gonna love you. You're in my prayers and my thoughts. Peace.